At the beginning of the movie recap, we talked about the magic mask. It was no ordinary mask. It was formed from the bones of many kings. At that time, there were magicians who practiced black magic. They put magical powers into this mask with the help of demons. Many pure girls were sacrificed. They were sacrificed, so the devil will be happy and give magicians more powers. This is how the mask becomes magical. The tribe begins to cast others who have worn this mask, turn people into devoted servants. They oppress the whole world when using this mask false. But then a tribe called the Barbarians arrived. The people of this tribe were brave and powerful. They rip off the mask of the evil tribe. They save it, so no one can misuse it. Now this mask was divided into pieces and each piece was given to each leader. Thus the mask was divided into many parts. No one can search this mask again, or you can't join it otherwise, the evil forces will return. It was prophesied that a person would come to rejoin this mask. He gets this mask. One more prediction was about a warrior. He will be the bravest, and he will fight for his tribe. Then after some time we see that the war continues. During the war, a female warrior gives birth to a son. The condition of the warrior was worse. She could not survive. But before she died, she named her son Conan. Many years have passed since this event. We see an attractive village. There was peace and people lived happily together. There was a good-hearted leader. Actually, the warrior we saw was his wife. Her son Conan was the son of this leader. Here we see Conan. He got old. He calls the leader a basket of eggs. He says, "Everyone, I am giving you a challenge. You all go to the mountains while putting egg in your mouth. The one who returns with the egg without breaking or damaging it, he wins and I give him a reward." Conan says to his father, "May I go with them?" His father says, "You are not that old yet." Conan says, "Let me go, please. I am your son and I can do huge tasks." Father sends him. Now the people of this tribe are moving towards the mountains. Everyone is trying to get over the mountain and come back, telling the tribe leader on the road ahead that the egg is perfectly fine. "We also crossed the mountain and came back." They were on the mountain and meanwhile a strange man came there. He was a cannibal. It hunts humans and uses them to eat their flesh. Other people of that tribe also come there, and they start attacking this tribe. But Conan defeats them all. He cuts their heads off. He comes to his father and takes their heads. The tribe leader couldn't believe it, that his son is brave. It also teaches him sword skills and enables him to become a good warrior. Then we see that these days there was an attack on the village. The man who was prophesied did, that a man will come and try to get the mask. That's why they attack the village, because it has the other parts of the mask. He just wants the last part. For this they hold the king. Now the man says to the king, "Who gives me the last part of the mask?" The leader says, "You say and I give you." "Never." The evil man orders his companion to kill the leader. But then Conan comes in and cuts the man's nose. He says, "No one will touch my father." The evil man who was looking for the mask was named Collar. She has a daughter. He has the ability to feel every bit of the mask, where it is. Collar goes to his daughter and asks her to feel each piece of the mask, because we have to join it. The girl is looking for pieces. On the other hand, Conan and his father were bound. There was nothing they could do. Collar bound them as if there was molten lava above them. If one of them makes a move and leaves the rope, lava will fall on them. That's why Conan has a strong grip on the rope, so that the lava could not fall on his father. That's why his hands were injured. When the leader sees this, in order to save his son, he drops the laver on him. It means he sacrificed his life to save his son Conan. Now Collar was happy because he has all the mask parts. Their connection was left, for that he needs pure blood. He leaves there, but Conan was there. We see that many years have passed. Conan has aged. Conan fought many times and killed many people, but still he could not find Collar. He was the man his father was killed for. Conan wants revenge on him. He wants to kill him and yet he was looking for him. He comes to a place while walking. There were many slaves. Women and slaves were oppressed there. Now Conan and his friend planned to free these slaves, and they did the same. They managed to free the slaves. They move forward. Conan sees a man there whose nose has been cut off. Conan immediately recognizes that this is the man whose nose I cut off. He discovers that he is Collar's companion. "He can help take me to Collar. They were looking for thieves. He's with Conan." Conan also reveals to them that he is the thief's companion. He also gets arrested. Now she is dating them. They reach their place of residence. Conan kills all the men there. A man with a cut-off nose was punishing a thief. Conan goes there and saves the thief. Then he asks the man, "Where is Collar?" A man without a nose asks him, "Who are you? And why are you asking about Collar?" Conan says, "Maybe you forgot about me. I'm the one who cut off your nose." Conan scares the man and tells him all about Collar. Then Conan arrives at the village and sees a girl there. Her name was Tamara. She was a good and pious girl. Her blood was pure. Collar comes there to take her with her daughter. They attack the villagers, but Tamara runs away from there. Collar sends his companion to Tamara. Conan also chases the girl. The girl was in the cart and Conan thinks Collar is in that cart. But when he saw that the girl was there, he asks her where is Collar. The girl says it, how should I know? I run from him too. Meanwhile, Collar's companions who were there to capture Tamara arrive. But Conan takes Tamara with him when he fights them. He thought Collar would come here looking for her. Then I'll hold him. There, Conan asks the wounded man for Collar's address. When it knows the address, it sends him a message. The girl you're looking for is with me. If you want her, come to me. Collar goes there with his daughter. He tells Conan that I will give you the money or gold you want. Conan refuses and says I don't need the money. I want your head. I want your life. Collar says that are you mad? Now Collar tells his daughter to teach him a lesson. And bring me Tamara. Collar's daughter does something with magic. They were mud like devils. They go and attack Conan. Conan defeated them in battle. But the devils weren't done. Conan was gradually completing them. Then Collar comes to fight him directly. They fight a lot. But when Collar's daughter sees Conan kill her father, he attacks Conan. Conan runs away with Tamara. Because he felt weak, he runs away from there with that thief. Across the sea, they go far from here. They were on a ship and night appeared. They were resting, but then their ship was attacked. Collar and their companions attack them. Conan and Tamara are immediately active. They fight them. Here, Conan is impressed by Tamara's fighting skills. He tells her that excellent, you fight so well. Hearing this, Tamara is happy. They like each other in a short time. But the next morning Tamara says I have to leave. She says goodbye to Conan and was about to leave. But then someone attacks her. Collar's companion takes Tamara with him. Conan chases after them. The place where Collar bound Tamara was a mysterious and narrow place. Before going there, Conan goes to see the man who helped him. That means a thief. He takes him with him to that place. They get outside the tunnel. It was locked, but the thief opened it. When they entered the tunnel, there were many dead bodies, and their skeletons too. Next, he sees that there is a huge and dangerous monster in the water. He is about to attack them. They run out of there and get out. They killed the monster and now they were looking for Tamara. Eventually, they reached the cave where Tamara's blood poured into the mask. To join the mask and bring the evil powers back in the mask. Collar donned this mask after throwing Tamara's blood on the mask. He became powerful. On the other hand, we see that Collar's daughter was attacking Tamara. Kill her, because she was useless now. They did the mask well, but then Conan arrives there and kills Collar's daughter. Then we see Collar coming there. He was standing on a wooden bridge. Meanwhile, Conan comes there and says that you have been eliminated. He breaks the wooden bridge and Collar fell into the ditch. He is dying. Everything was falling and falling apart. Conan saves Tamara. He takes her out with him. Here the prediction was completely confirmed. That a brave warrior will come and defeat this man. A man who will use the mask incorrectly. This is where humanity wins. That's the end of this movie. Thanks for watching the story recap.